First at 4, San Antonio police have a suspect in custody in connection to the overnight vandalism of the Alamo Cenotaph. Eyewitness News reporter Mariah Medina is live at Alamo Plaza with the latest. Mariah.
Sharon, there were at least three incidents of vandalism here overnight. Authorities arrested 25-year-old Noah Benjamin Escamilla in connection with at least one of those incidents. But San Antonio police tell me they suspect Escamilla in connection with the vandalism here at the Cenotaph.
We still have further to investigate, but right now I think we feel that we have a pretty good suspect.
San Antonio Police Chief William McManus saying they know who may be behind the bright red message spray painted on the historic sculpture in Alamo Plaza overnight. The sculpture has long been a point of contention after city leaders last year voted to move forward with the relocation of the sculpture as part of the Alamo redesign master plan.
I can't believe it. I'm very, very angry.
Ramon Garza and Lupe Rivera are among those who think the cenotaph should not be moved. They say they were disappointed to learn of the vandalism. Rivera says the perpetrator was likely ignorant to the historic value of the sculpture.
Get educated. That's all I can say. Get educated.
While the FBI was seen at the site of the vandalism, it's unclear whether the suspect could face federal charges. McManus says police are aware these messages could be tied to protests across the country in wake of the death of George Floyd, who died in the custody of the Minneapolis police. The department McManus once headed himself.
I think given the political temperature and what's going on in the country and, I mean, what's going on up in cities up north, I think possibly that could play into it.
And staff from the Alamo have since covered the message with butcher paper and tape, as you can see right behind me. Councilman Roberto Trevino, who represents this area, recently spoke. He said that they're going to step up patrols in this area so that this doesn't happen again. He also added that they're working with experts to have this removed professionally. Mariah Medina, KENS 5 Eyewitness News.